So today let's take a look at an interesting digital mechanical clock. It's antique from about 70s, it's made by Bosch and it has a display which is digital, but it's not a normal LED display or any other type of electronic display. It's purely mechanical. As you can see, there are just flipping cards in it. And there is an alarm as well in it. And here's a button to activate or deactivate the alarm. Here's an adjustment knob to adjust the running speed of the clock. And that's more or less it. And there is a space for batteries. It's for those two batteries, C size. It's size C and there are supposed to be two of them, but those batteries are in parallel, not in series, so it actually runs on just one of them. And it's made by Bosch in Germany and the type is UDW1 or UDV1 in German. It's quite a simple clock with just a time display and the alarm setting. And this knob has two parts. One of them is setting the time in 24-hour mode, as you can see, and the other part of it is setting the alarm like this. And the time goes only forward, you can't go back, so it may actually take some time to set it. And on the other hand, the alarm goes only backwards, not forward. There is a wheel with not much resolution. There is about 6 clicks per hour. So you set it with 10 minute resolution. And now let's try to activate the alarm. And it actually starts at the wrong time. It's set to 17, but it starts at 7. But it seems to run well. It's nicely flipping, it's nicely synchronized, it flips when it's at 59 and when it goes to zeros, the hours flip, which is right. It's actually running a little bit too fast, but it can be adjusted. And here's the adjustment knob, turning it to the right or clockwise makes it slower and turning it to the left or counterclockwise makes it faster. But now let's take a look in it. There should be some screws under this cover or stand also. It can come off and here you can see the screws, but there is also a sticky tape on it. So it seems somebody broke it and repaired it. So let's remove the sticky tape and the cover of course comes off, because there are some plastic pieces already broken and they are here, one here and the other one here, so I don't have to remove the screws to open it. And those are here and it seems like somebody didn't know that the screws are under this cover, so he was just basically prying it open and broke it. And now it's opened and you can see the mechanism. And because the clock is running too fast and because this knob actually makes it faster when turning to the left, I think that somebody mistaken it for a screw that has to be removed to open it and was turning it to the left or counterclockwise, which made it way too fast. So it seems like somebody broke the cover because he didn't know how to open it and he was also turning this adjustment knob like crazy. And now it comes out of the box. And that's it. You can see the broken pieces of plastic. And the other one. And as you can see, there are no electronic components in it, it's purely mechanical. There are just various wheels, gears, there is an escapement in it, a balance wheel, a motor which is winding a spring, and then the spring is powering it. Here is the spring, and there is also some contact activating the motor, and a contact activating the arm, which is just a coil and some contacts, so it vibrates, and that's more or less it. And there are some other gears moving the drums with the cards. And the hours have to be synchronized with the minutes. So the hours flip exactly when the minutes go from 59 to 0. And as you can see, the minutes from 40 on have this extra bit on it here. And this bit is pushing this hook, and this hook is holding the hours. So the hours don't flip until it reaches zeros. Now it's 59, which is the last one with this extra bit. And now it all flips. And the alarm activator basically is just this contact here, sliding on a plastic ring. And then it clicks into a gap with the other contact and activates the alarm. Now it's sliding. Here's the gap with the other contact. It clicks in and that's it. And this contact moves with the clock. And because there is 60 minutes but only 24 hours, each card is twice here. As you can see, so the number of cards in hours is closer to the number of cards in minutes. So sometimes the hours flip without changing the number. Right now. But in minutes each number is there just once. Here you can see the gears of hours and minutes. The alarm is basically just an electromagnet with vibrating contacts here. Here is the alarm switch making contact here. Here is the one-way mechanism of the alarm wheel. Here you can see the battery space with the batteries in parallel. The positive is in the center and the negatives are commoned together using this strip. And here you can see the other interesting parts of it. Here is the escapement. Can you see it? Here is the balance wheel, the hairspring and the speed adjustment mechanism. And this piece of metal has a gap in it and the hairspring is going through the gap. And when you turn it, you can make the spring longer or shorter to make it run slower or faster. Every time the balance wheel moves back and forth, the escape wheel moves by one tooth. It's just like in a normal mechanical clock, but instead of hands, it moves the flipping cards. And just like a normal mechanical clock, it's powered by a spring. But unlike in a mechanical clock, you don't have to wind it manually. Because in this clock, a motor does it for you. Here you can see the motor with some wires, and it has a warm drive turning those wheels and winding this spring here. When the spring is running out, the motor winds it automatically. And there is a mechanism with a contact, and when the spring is running out, the motor winds it quickly and turns off. So basically every maybe few minutes, the motor turns on for like 1 second and winds it. And here you can see a reed switch in a glass tube, the green one, and a magnet here. When the spring is running out, this magnet falls down to the switch. It turns it on, activates the motor, and the motor winds the spring. And then this magnet goes back up. Let's wait for it. So it's basically a mechanical clock with a motor winding it for you and with flipping cards instead of hands. So I managed to fix the alarm. The sliding contact was just moved here. Now I have to adjust the running speed and fix those broken holders. And it's more or less restored. So this is Diagon Wild, and see you in my next videos. And thanks to all of my patrons on Patreon. I really appreciate your support.